Hello friend, I am Alex. So today I am just talking about how we can install a CentOS panel on KVM based machine. So KVM basically a virtualization technology that is used to create multiple server on a single hardware. So before starting, I have to log into my panel. It is my base machine. Just wait. Okay. So this is my KVM based machine. It's known as Promox panel. So I have created a lot of server here. And this is the server, a little demo, then how can create a fresh server CentOS 7. So there is the option, multiple option. So I create a host name, this is the VM ID, and this is the node name SRV. Okay, this I type here host dot demo CentOS.com. Just hold down 1 minute. TK. Okay, I go to the next step. There is the different OS type, Linux as well as Windows, and with different template. So, and this is the my local storage. So I have select here and I select the image CentOS 6.9. Okay, and I go to the next step. Okay, there is the disk space I have to assign for my particular VM. So I have assigned here 30 GB disk space, and there is the another option CPU. So I have assigned 1 core and assigned 1 GB RAM for this server. So I go to the next step, and this is the network setting, and now go to the next step, and this is the my last step, which is the all description about the my VM, like its networking name, socket, VM ID, and this some more things. Now I have finished this installation, and I have checked the VM ID 104 has started, and this is the status, and this is the output. Okay, and now I have start this server. So wait for little moment. Okay, now this is started. So I log into the console panel to allow the pop-up utility here. So I go to the console panel and check from initialization to last step where it is installed. So I can copy this URL from here and browse here. Okay, this is the primary step of installation. So this is the install and upgrade the existing system, install a fresh system. So I click here and go to the booting scenario. So it is initialized. So I am checking the disk space utility. I check the inserted drive is proper or not. So it is successfully verified, and I press OK and go to the next step. I press OK and go to the continuous next step. Okay, this is the some graphical view where I can install a fresh CentOS server. Okay, this is go to the next step, and this is the language utility, which language you want to select. So I select here, this is the Netherlands, Poles, Pots, Romania, and different language here. So I select by default English with United States. Go to the upper end and come back downward and check, there is different language, Japan, Hong Kong, Greek, France. So you can select any of the language according to your location, which so I will select here for English. So I go to the search the English language here. Just hold on 1 minute. Oh, just wait. Okay, so I have selected English from here and go to the next step. Because there is the graphical environment, so pixel base, so this is the small, so I cannot find the correct one. So I have selected English, US English, and go to the next step and check there is the what environment you want to install for a hard disk. There is the two, basic storage and specialized storage. Specialized storage, that means you can mount any iSCSI drive on your server, or in other way you can install the given hardware. So go to the console panel, because I cannot view the correct environment. This is connecting. Okay, so I have installed basic setup, and go to the next step. Go to the next step and go to the next step, and this is the server host name. So I type host dot demo CentOS dot tk. Okay, go to the next step. So this is the language, select the language, select the location. So I bypass these things and go to the next step, and this is the password. So I type password for root login. So I type here password, and type same credential for root user. So now go to the next step. So this is weak password, but by I have passed away these things, and this is the again strategy what you want to set up the hard disk partition on your system. So I bypass and use all space. It means 30 GB space is utilized for our hardware. And now go to the next step. Okay, go to the next step and write changes to disk. That means use all space to our hardware. It means 30 GB spaces utilized to all your root partition, home partition, where, and different partition. So this process is starting, so it will take some time. So I pause the video at moment. Okay, now come back, it is installed, and reboot my system. So it will take 1 to 2 minutes to. Okay. So I type the user root and the password I have set before the server installation. So I go to the if config, there is no network configuration setup here. So I go to the directory etc sysconfig network utility network script, and I go to the directory here. So there is a different file here, so I have to go only ifcfg eth0 ifcfg eth0. Okay, So this is the basically network information related file. So I have to change here some entity and allow static boot priority and add IP address. And this is the my test file where I assign the IP address. This is IP address 69.197.143.254. Okay, and the net mask is 255.255.255. So just late 255.248. And this is the gateway to bypass my network to globally. And this is the 69.197.143.249. I have to save this file and start the networking service. Service network restart. Okay, it is successfully started, and now I check if config file. So it is not visual here, but I start the up the ETH zero interface. Okay, now it is up, and now I check again if config file. So I have found the network is seen here and ping the google.com. Google is still unpingable, so I go to the resolve.com file and add the entity Google name server in this file 8.8.8.1. and after now this is the second name server 8.8.4.4. okay, now save the file and again ping the google.com. So it is successfully ping google.com. Now I have to start SSH service for outside pingable or outside accessible. So copy this IP and paste here and open. So this is the root username and this is the password. Okay, now I check if config file. This is the my IP address and I have to again ping google.com by outside the private network. So this is ping . So in this video we can learn how can we install extend CentOS panel or a virtualization technology. So please like this video and share this video and comment this video. If you need more video, please like my page and share it. Thank you for watching.